The city of Utica hoping new emergency stations like this will actually help deter crime in a park that's seen its share of trouble lately. Grant Park has had a murder and a dog left for dead in a matter of just 4 months. Well, Nick Monticelli reports the very latest, and Utica's mayor believes that the perception alone will help.
The memorial for Sterling, the dog that was killed and left here in Grant Park, is still standing. His picture is still on the poster boards under this pavilion. Now, there is talk about putting two of these poles in this park. When you talk to residents, they're not so sure about it. Some are, some aren't. But the mayor says this is absolutely happening. Grant Park has seen its share of negative headlines lately. Sterling, a 3-year-old pit bull mix, was tortured and left to die in the park last month. And in September, Michael Chirito was stabbed to death at his grandkids' birthday party after asking a man to stop doing drugs near the children. So Utica Mayor Tom Dion wants to install two emergency stations like these in the park. The Downtown Development Authority will cover the cost, which won't be higher than $15,000 for now. A West Michigan company, Code Blue, has been awarded the job, and there are add-on options like cameras or AED devices. For now, it's going to be a phone that connects to Utica's dispatch with an emergency blue light. Dion, who is also a Grosse Pointe Farms police officer, says that light is a reminder.
So that blue light is a mental reminder to people that there's a police presence and that police can be there at any moment to handle a situation.
I like the idea.
Utica residents seem split on the decision, though.
And I'm not opposed to the cost either. It's really a drop in the bucket.
Robert Colasso thinks there's a different motive.
I see a little bit of politics behind it, for the simple fact of here's what we're doing to help make you feel safer.
But the mayor says if that's how some feel, so be it.
There has to be a response from our residents. They're demanding that something be done. It's either we hire more police officers, which is a knee-jerk reaction with huge costs, which we're not afraid to do that. But we have to go to the residents for that because we need a millage for that. But an immediate response that we can't afford right away that makes a meaningful impact would be these blue light poles.
In Utica, Nick Monticelli, Local 4.